Welcome to Excellent CAD. My name is Ajay Anand. In this video, I will show you how to create a dynamic drop-down list which will hide the used items. First of all, let me show you what I mean. Here I have a list of tasks related to a particular project. And here are my team members. Now to assign a person for a particular task, for example, this task survey, select the corresponding cell. Here I have a drop-down menu and all my team members are listed here. For survey, I will assign Hannah. Now for design and calculation, select the corresponding cell. Again, drop-down menu. See, Hannah is not shown in this list. The reason being, we have already assigned Hannah to survey. So let me assign John for design and calculation. Again, for drawings. Again, both John and Hannah are not shown in the list as they are assigned for another task. So let me show you how to create a dynamic drop-down list like this. This is the same template which we saw a moment before. So to create a dynamic drop-down list of this person's listed here, first of all, I will create a dynamic copy of this list, a list that will update automatically every time when we use a value from it. For that, I will be using filter function equal filter function open parenthesis first argument array. Select the list of team members, comma, second argument include. Here we have to specify the condition for filter. I will be using countif function for that. Open parenthesis, first argument range. Select the range where we will be using these values. Select the range of cells from D3 to D7, comma, criteria. Select the list of team members, close parenthesis. Equal 0. So we want to filter those names whose count is 0 in this range. Close parenthesis and press the enter key. Filter function has returned the entire list. And now when I use a name from this list, for example Tara, that name will disappear from the second list. Once again Nisha. So we have a dynamic list which will update automatically whenever we use a value from that list. To create a drop-down list from this dynamic list, I will delete these values, select this cell, in the data tab, data validation, for validation criteria, select list, click on this input box, equal, select the cell H3 which contains the dynamic list. Now use the spill range operator hash, which will refer to the entire spill range. Type in hash. Okay. Now D3 has a drop-down menu which contains the list of team members. Copy this drop-down menu into the adjacent cells below. We'll assign Tara for survey. Now Tara is not listed in the second drop-down menu. Sit. Nisha, Peter, Hannah. Now if you want to change a selection, select that cell, delete. Once again, click on the drop-down menu, select another person. And I always recommend to use Excel tables while creating drop-down lists. The reason being, Excel tables are dynamic and can handle addition of new items. Let me add a new name here, Ajay. Check the drop-down list. See, the drop-down list remains the same. Now let me show you the difference when this list is an Excel table. I'll delete this value. To convert this list into an Excel table, select the list, insert, table, okay. And our list has been converted into an Excel table. Check the drop-down menu. Drop-down menu is the same. Let me add a new name here, Ajay. Now check the drop-down menu. The drop-down menu has been updated with the newly added value. Once again, we can also combine this kind of dynamic list with dependent drop-down list, and I will explain that in another video. I hope you will find this video useful. For feedback and discussion, please make use of the comment section. And those who are visiting this channel for the first time, subscribe and press the bell icon so that you won't miss anything. Thanks for watching. Wish you a great day.